Thank you so much. Well, you look like a happy bunch, so sing with me. I have the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Really great, as I expected. You did a great job as my choir the last time we were here in concert with our Caterpillar Butterfly program. So I want you to help me make a choir arrangement of I Have the Joy. Now, first thing, let's put a big ending on it. When you get to this part, go, let's see. I have the joy. Joy, joy, joy. Comes in. Down in my heart to stay. The way I want you to hit that last note. Now you can do it. Remember the music lesson from last time? Singing high is just screaming on pitch. Okay, let's practice this ending. Now, even though this is a practice, I really want you to sing it out anyway. You start with, you know, down in my heart. Here we go. Sing it.
Down in my heart to stay.
Some guy turning blue in the face. Why practice something you're going to get anyway? Let's just go back to the beginning. And here's what I'd like you to do in the choir number. I want you to sing it the regular way one time through. Then I'll sing a middle part by myself. You come back in and sing the chorus a second time, adding the big ending. Now, the second time you come in, I'd like for you to stand. You got it? If you have it, say, I have it. You're a bunch of fakers, but I love it. Okay, together now. Here we go.
I have the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. Down in my heart. I have the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart to stay.
I have the grandest, greatest feeling. This feeling's really here to stay. And it's a joy that needs revealing. So I just want to say,
I have the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. Down in my heart. I have the joy, 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 joy down in my
heart. Here we go now.
Down in my heart to stay.
Give yourself a big hand. This quartet number is an old-fashioned number that you may recognize. You may have heard Sandy do it in some of her concerts. Well, remember, she got it from me.
I told all my troubles goodbye. Goodbye to each tear and each sigh. This world where I roam cannot be my home. I'm bound for a land in the sky. A day, maybe two, then goodbye. Tomorrow I'm living on high. Heaven is near and I can stay here. Goodbye, world, goodbye. Now don't you weep for me when I'm gone. Cause I won't have to leave here alone. And when I hear that last trumpet sound, my feet won't stay on the ground. Gonna rise, gonna rise, gonna fly. Gonna ride with my Lord to the sky. Heaven is near and I can stay here. Goodbye, world, goodbye. trumpet sound. My feet won't stay on the ground.
I saw a lot of you looking at Carolyn at the piano while I was up here singing my heart out. And that's fine with me. Carolyn's definitely the prettiest one in our concerts. And she really is the most talented one of us all. All of our children are talented, but not as much as Carolyn. As you may remember from the last concert we gave here, Carolyn is quite a classical pianist as well as a gospel accompanist. She has a real gift of putting the gospel and the classics together in beautiful piano solos. And she has her arrangement of Stand Up for Jesus that I know you're going to really like. She adds within the gospel song, Stand Up for Jesus, a prelude by Rachmaninoff. But at the beginning and the end, she adds some real challenging, beautiful runs, I call them. When I heard her putting this number together, I said, honey, you got to use that in your arrangement. She said, Ron, I'm just practicing. This is only a piano exercise. But I said, it sounds so great. People will never know that it's not a real number. Please put it in. So she put it in, and it does sound great, as you will see. Honey? You're going to hear more from Carolyn later. But now, this next quartet number really sets the stage for what we'd like to share with you in this program. I want you, if you will, Listen carefully to the words, because when the sun goes down, I thank my God. In the fall or spring, I thank my God. And when it seems like troubles turn me aside, I can ask for help, I'll not be denied. When it seems my work has been in vain, then I think the price was paid when Christ was slain. Every morning, evening, noon or night, matters not what may befall, I will sing God's praise and thank my Savior for it all. There's a million things I'd like to do to serve my Lord. There are many truths I find each day in God's own word. All the things on earth I might achieve, though great or small, I will thank my God because I know He owns them all.
Now when the sun goes down and nighttime falls,
I thank my God. And in the fall
or spring,
I thank my God. When it seems like trouble alone to turn me aside, I can ask for help and rest assured I'll not be denied. When it seems like all my work I've done has been in vain, then I think the price was paid when Christ was slain. Every morning, evening, noon or night, matters not what may befall, I will sing God's praise and thank my Savior for it all. Yes, I'll sing God's praise and thank my Savior for it all.
Wow, thank you. Boy, it's great to sing to you. Thank you. You know, that's a pretty fast-moving song, and if you're not careful, you might say that the message in the song is not very serious. But when you start singing about thanking God all the time, that gets to be pretty serious business. Because if you're like we are, you have troubles, burdens, heartaches, and all kinds of things that come at you in a hurtful way. Yet here I am up here saying, hey, be thankful anyway. And that's not easy, to always be thankful no matter what. But it is scriptural. The Bible says, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God. I guess I learned that lesson the best when we were going through some problems with our son Mike. Mike was our prodigal son for 7 years. In our previous concert, I had mentioned how God had taken caterpillar situations in our family and had made butterflies out of them. Well, Mike was one of those caterpillars. He had left home after he got out of high school. He said that he was tired of God, of church, of religion, and that he wanted to see the other side of life. So he headed off down the street to find out about the other side of life. Of course, Carolyn and I were almost devastated. We went around during those 7 years with an emptiness in our hearts. And I'm sure many of you here in this concert know how we felt. Well, one day while we were out in South Carolina on tour, I was jogging on the beach and I noticed a little oyster shell lying there in the sand. This encounter changed my thinking about hurts and how to be thankful in the midst of them. You see, I knew that the only way an oyster could make a pearl was from a hurt inside him. As I picked up the little shell, it was almost as if the little oyster said to me, "Ron, you're God's highest creation. Surely God is going to help you make a pearl out of Mike." Well, I was so encouraged. When I told Carolyn what had happened, she was encouraged too. I even wrote a poem about the little oyster that I want to share with you later. But first, this good news. Not too long after the oyster incident, now remember, this hurt had been going on for 7 years. Mike called. He was crying, and he told us how grateful he was that when he was a little boy, we had told him the story of the good shepherd who left the 99 sheep who were safe and went out to look for that last lost sheep until he found it. Mike said, "Mom and Dad, I was that lost sheep, and God found me to today. He told us that he had given his life to Christ, along with his wife, Lee Ann. Then our first two little grandkids came along, Melissa and Chris. You see, God had made four pearls out of what we thought was an impossible hurt. So our message to you in this concert is simple. If you have a hurt right now, I have good news for you. It takes a hurt to make a pearl. There are no real pearls without first a hurt. And God is not going to give up on your hurt until a pearl is made. So be encouraged. Well, this next package is especially for those who have hurts. We begin with the story of Sinner Man. This is Mike's story. He tries to run from God, but God keeps on his trail until Mike is ready to come home. Then Carolyn sings, "There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul." Then I want to share with you the poem that I wrote about the oyster and the pearl. But go with me now as we see God searching and searching and searching for some little lost sheep called Sinner Man. Sinner Man, where you gonna run to? Oh, Sinner Man, where you gonna run to? Oh, Sinner Man, where you gonna run to when God calls on you? Well, I'll run to my friends. Friends, won't you hide me? I'll run to my friends. Friends, won't you hide me? I'll run to my friends. Friends, won't you hide me? All on that day. But the Lord said, "Sinner man, your friends can never hide you." The Lord said, "Sinner man, your friends can never hide you." The Lord said, "Sinner man, your friends can never hide you." All on that day. Then I'll run to my gold. Gold, won't you help me? I'll run to my gold. Gold, won't you help me? I'll run to my gold. Gold, won't you help me? All on that day. But the Lord said, "Sinner man, your gold will soon be melting." The Lord said, "Sinner man, your gold will soon be melting." The Lord said, "Sinner man, your gold will soon be melting." All on that day. Then I'll run to the church. Church, won't you save me? I'll run to the church. Church, won't you save me? I'll run to the church. Church, won't you save me? All on that day. But the Lord said, "Sinner man, church can never save you." The Lord said, "Sinner man, church can never save you." The Lord said, "Sinner man, church can never save you." All on that day. Then Jesus, Jesus, won't you help me? Jesus, Jesus, won't you help me? Jesus, won't you save me? Now, Jesus said, "Sinner man, run right in." Jesus said, "Sinner man, run right in." Jesus said, "Sinner man, run right in." Oh.
give up.
God is never going to give up because
there is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. Sometimes I feel discouraged and think my work's in vain, but then the Holy Spirit revives my soul again. If you cannot preach like Peter, if you cannot pray like Paul, you can tell the love of Jesus and say, He died for all.
He died for all.
Born as our other oysters, however that may be, just a tiny little shell living in the deep blue sea. He wasn't very pretty and looked to me like he was sad, but for an ordinary oyster, he really wasn't all that bad. But he began to grow and grow, seemed a happy little thing, until a tiny grain of sand lodged inside and began to sting. "Ouch, that hurts," I heard the little oyster say. Little did he know the change that would begin in him that day. For that little grain of sand dug in and hurt him more and more, until within the oyster grew a very painful sore. The oyster cried and cried until he had no more tears to shed, and sometimes he would even pray as he would lie upon his bed. But every teardrop fell right on that painful hurt, until those tears surrounded that annoying piece of dirt. The teardrops circled round and round and held the hurt quite fast. And soon our little oyster knew he was finally well at last. Well, time went by, and fishermen finally reached the little shell of that little oyster. Now mature, with quite a story he could tell, for now he was a treasure chest. A big surprise he did unfurl, because from his hurt, why, that little oyster had produced a giant pearl. And so it is with you and me. The hurts come day by day, but God has built within each one a very special way to make our weaknesses our strength, our hurts a way to Him. And He has promised to be with us, to make our hurts a priceless gem. You say, "Ron, that's a nice poem, but I have such a big hurt that I don't know if God can really make something good happen or not." Well, I hope you don't feel that way, but just in case you need a little more encouragement, Carol and I have a song that gives three examples of how God has taken impossible situations and made something good happen. Not in spite of the situations, but because of the situation. We take two examples from the Old Testament and one from the New Testament. Familiar stories to you, I'm sure. But in order for us to do this our best, we need you to help us and make this another choir number. In the song, there are three pearl-making choruses that come in from time to time, and I want you to sing those familiar choruses, "Standing on the Promises," "He's got the whole world in His hands," then "Glory, glory, hallelujah, His truth is marching on." And when you sing, I'd like for you to stand. then sit down. Then stand again and sit back down. Three different times I'd like for you to stand and sit. Now, if you do this standing and sitting right, you can make a pearl out of your weight. That's right. This one song could help you lose 3 pounds. Now, Carolyn begins things by telling us how God and David made a pearl out of a hopeless situation. Honey?
When David stood before Goliath with his sling, the people laughed at such a puny little thing. But David knew his faith in God would stand the test. He flung the rock.
He flung the rock.
God did the rest.
Sing it together.
Stand. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior.
Oh, that sounds
great. Standing on the promises of God.
Great job.
Old Daniel sat
within the hungry lion's den.
Nobody thought
that there was any hope for him, but all night long. Those lions never took a bite. You know why? God took away their appetite.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world.
That's it.
In his hands. He's got the whole world.
He has you and your hurt.
In his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
I read about how Paul and Silas were in jail and no one there.
Trouble or care, the good Lord can't relieve. Oh, he is just the same today. All you have to do is just trust and pray and believe. You must believe.
Go ahead, give yourself a hand. Great job. Oh, I really love the way you help us in these concerts.